We're probably in better shape than we've been in the last 20 years. We've done a considerable amount of work after the Cerro Grande Fire, the Las Conchas Fire, and with the establishment of the LANL Wildland Fire Program Office now, we've been very successful in completing a strategy of defensible space around the laboratory, around the perimeter, as well as around the buildings and structures. We're never going to eliminate the fire hazard. We know fire is always going to be a potential, but we want to eliminate the devastating effects of a wildland fire and protect the people and infrastructure. We still have some areas, the interior areas, that haven't been treated, that they're still susceptible to fire, that haven't burned in over 100 years. However, I think we've reduced the capacity for fires, new starts, to be the catastrophic-type fires we experienced during the Cerro Grande and Las Conchas. However, a lightning strike can occur anywhere. And if it occurs in the interior that has not burned, the potential for a devastating fire is still there. Just be aware that there is a line, and the hazard has not disappeared. This is property that DOE has leased to the Park Service, and they sublet to the Forest Service and to us for office space. It's the Interagency Fire Base out at TA 49. Basically a powerhouse of fire managers for the region. So we have fire specialists from all three agencies now that cooperate on fuels projects. The talent pool here is incredible. We've got firefighters here now that have fought fire all over the country, fire behavior specialists. We're not only relying on the local resources, but we can have at our fingertips regional access to federal resources very, very quickly, which is a huge asset to the laboratory.
It will give you the 3D effect.
We've got the technology that we use now, with the SIMS table, the modeling, the communications that we've enhanced, not only with the face-to-face interaction with the group here, but with the LANL management, emergency management, and the communications there are just light years from what we used to use. The systems that we use now, the modeling capability we have is real time, and it's available to responders out in the field as well as the modelers here. So I think that's what we bring to the table is the LANL part of this interagency fire base, is we bring that technology and supply it to the guys that are actually out there, boots on the ground, that are stomping these fires out. Our goal is to be a good neighbor. We want to prevent fire from escaping from the laboratory, from our operations or activities. And we want to make sure that if we protect ourselves from fire coming off adjoining lands. With an overall wildland management strategy for the laboratory, the entire facility, I think we've been much more effective in protecting the general area and the community as well as the laboratory.